Okay, you gotta look at this video for Dan, and it's unfortunate that you're getting some losses, man, but hey, it happens with the best of us. So here, my starting play would have been the Tesla in the center. You can cycle that pretty happily, rather than leaking a bit of elixir here at the start. The late bomber wasn't a bad play at all. The Tesla would have stopped the fire spirits, and it's just a good cycle at the start of the game. Bomber does a little bit of work here, but man, you were just leaking elixir like crazy. You really want to get out of that habit. It's actually going to hinder the game. This E-barb rush was pretty horrible. I mean, you would have got really good value out of arrows just then. You would have got a +2 elixir trade. Waited really late on those, and the Tesla was placed way too late. Once again, that Tesla would have still been active if that was the first card you played, and it would have dealt with the prince pretty well. And the E-barb there, rush there really wasn't going to work. You were rushing straight into a furnace and straight into a guy that had a lot of elixir stored up. See how the Tesla is stopping the fire spirits from touching you? That's a really good placement. I would have placed it maybe one tile towards the right a little bit just to keep it centered, so it pulls a hog in from both sides if they have that card, as this player does. Pekka cycled in the back. It's a questionable one. You really want to keep that for the tank, for the hog rider, or the prince. Cycling it like that, you have to have somewhat of a plan, and this deck is very swarmy. It's sort of a hog bait variant almost, with a little bit of bridge spam. Nice archers. Archers behind the Pekka is always a good time. Unfortunately, running into a wizard there. Once again here, I would have probably dropped the Tesla in the center. You're putting down pretty much your win condition. And the rage here, that was I'm not going to lie, a horrible play. You're running into a lot of elixir. The prince was very, very predictable. And the E-barbs, especially at your level, are not going to counter that. Archers was about the best you could do with the zap there, unfortunately. It dealt with the threat pretty well. It wasn't ideal, but that's what you had, and that's all right. Nice work not throwing anything at those fire spirits. You didn't really have the cards to throw. The Pekka here, I would have probably played the right side. I was predicting they were going to push hard. Once again, dude, you're running into a prince every day. You're running into a prince, you're running into fire spirits, you're running into bats, you're running into minions, and you're not going to have the elixir. Spending 8 elixir like that is a very costly investment, and if you're not getting the value from it, it's not worth the play. And he can drop bats and minions on top of you, and the zap there is, yeah, it's good value, but you're still going to lose your win condition. And so running straight into the prince again. For this, if you face a similar deck in the future, I would drop the prince, drop the Pekka for the prince. Whenever they drop the prince, have Pekka ready. You can keep the E-barbs and the rage in your hand. You can even rage your archers, rage your bomber, rage your towers if you need to. They're all good plays, but other than that, it's just unfortunate that you're trying to rush too hard with this deck when it's not really the right play to make at times. But yeah, I hope this helps you out, man, and if any questions, just leave it in the clan chat, leave it on Discord, and like and subscribe if anyone else is watching, as usual. Cheers.